ஃபஸ்ட்டு வந்து ஸ்டேட்டஸ் எப்படி வந்து வெளியில் சொன்னேன் அப்படின்னா, இந்த ஸ்டேட்டஸ் வெளியில் தெரிஞ்சதுனால எங்களுடைய மாமியார் வீட்லேயும் எங்கள் அம்மா வீட்லேயும் எல்லோரும் என்னை விட்டு விலகி போயிட்டாங்க. அதுக்கப்புறம் உங்கள் ஒய்ஃபை கூட்டிகிட்டு வாங்கன்னு சொன்னதில் என்னை கூட்டிகிட்டு போய் டெஸ்ட் பண்ணார். அப்போ எனக்கு ஹெச்ஐவி எய்ட்ஸை பற்றி ஒன்றுமே தெரியாது. ஆனால் ரொம்ப அழுதேன், என்னடா இது இந்த மாதிரிலாம் டெஸ்ட் பண்ண வர சொல்கிறாங்களேன்னு. டெஸ்ட் பண்ணதில் எனக்கு வந்து ஹெச்ஐவி இருக்குன்னு சொல்லிட்டாங்க.
ஐ தாட் ஐ வாஸ் தி ஒன்லி ஒன் ஹூ இஸ் இன்ஃபெக்டட். அண்ட் தி ஒன்லி திங் இஸ் தட் லைக் நவ் ஐ அம் கோயிங் டு டை. அண்ட் தி டாக்டர் சேட் லைக் தேர் இஸ் ட்ரீட்மெண்ட் இஸ் தியர், தோ தேர் இஸ் நோ க்யூர் ட்ரீட்மெண்ட் இஸ் தியர்.
2004 में जब पता चला कि गवर्नमेंट से ARTI फ्री मिल रहा है, तो मैं जब गवर्नमेंट में गया मुझे फ्री ARTI मिला. और आज मुझे अभी मैं सेकंड लाइन ले रहा हूँ जो 2010 से, तो जो सपोर्ट अभी तक मुझे मिला ट्रीटमेंट से उससे मुझे बहुत फ़र्क लगा.
क्योंकि जब इन्फेक्शन का पता लगा तब तो यही लगा था कि शायद 6 महीना या साल भर में ज़िंदगी ख़त्म हो जाएगी. लेकिन जब से ARTI खाना चालू किया तो अपने आप को हम बहुत स्वस्थ महसूस करते हैं और प्रॉपर 12 से 14 घंटा वर्क भी करते हैं.
Waste control and the communities, I welcome you this morning to this celebration of 10 years of journey of ARTI in India.
Because of ARTI drugs, we have come to the stage of saying that HIV is an ordinary disease. We have saved more than 1.5 lakh lives in India, and we will continue to save. ARTI drugs have done this. Magic to create extent.
Now we are in the middle way of the journey of ARTI from nowhere to somewhere.
It is actually so very important because in India 10 years before we started the ARTI, when nothing was there in the infrastructure, even the medicines were not available and they were so expensive. But as the time passed on, actually the things changed.
It is almost unbelievable because time flies so fast, and it has been not that long ago that India has just initiated this program. And then if you look at what the accomplishments have been over 10 years, this is breathtaking, ladies and gentlemen. Congratulations to all of you with this indeed great accomplishment. Obviously, it would not have been possible had there not been such a high level of political commitment, not just from the Ministry of Health and health professionals, but I think also political commitment of all the players, multiple players in the sectorial action that government has given to it.
This is a time when I readily agreed to attend this function, mainly because the celebration is not only for the PLHAs, it's a celebration for us as well. And it gives me no greater satisfaction that program scaling up so beautifully and so well. So first of all, my congratulations to all of you, because it is the greatest partnership that I learned from. And today I'm extremely unhappy to see that people are standing there saying no drug stockout, it should not happen. And there are two unfinished agendas that I think need to be pursued. One is the computerization, that anywhere PLHA goes, any place in the country, he should be able to go and access his drugs by giving in the smart card. And the second is quality of care. If you take the proxy how many are survival rate, Dr. Rajshekar tells me when we were monitoring it was 78%, and today it is 70%. That's not good.
India has certainly scaled up rapidly over the last 10 years, and it's fascinating to see that in the last 10 years we have moved from almost nothing to nearly 750,000 odd people on treatment, which is great, but India still has a long way to go. My understanding is that we need at least 1.5 million people on treatment. Across the world, 89% of the generics for treatment comes from India. And if we are saying that only half our people are getting treatment, that's not good enough. And we are halfway there. We are around 52-54%. There is need for India to scale up.
Many people who were tested for HIV and were found to be positive, they did not come to the treatment centers because they were not counseled that this disease may occur without symptoms. I think the way we are scaling up is fine. Just try to ensure that it's universal coverage. Everybody who requires, including those high-risk groups, are covered.
See, there are two main challenges here. One is with all the scale-up, we are still covering only about 55% of the people who are in need of treatment in India. So there is a huge need to cover more people. That is on one side. Second is, how do we improve the quality of treatment, which also includes adherence, which also includes viral load monitoring and others, for the existing people. So basically, it is a twin challenge, and we need to look at it both the sides.
We have 4 CD4 machines in Nagaland, but all these 4 CD4 machines are frequently, it is breaking down. So we don't have viral load testing machine. The only testing machine that we have is the CD4 machine, where we can monitor our CD4.
Government have to create awareness and sensitization programs in the healthcare workers. Still, we face discrimination among the hospitals, healthcare workers in surgeries, treatments and all.
AIT जो first line लिया तो उसका मैंने 8 साल लिया, उसके बाद मुझे उसका side effect हुआ. 7-8 महीने तक मैंने बोला, उसके बाद मेरा viral load test करवाया. पहले मुझे बोला गया कि अभी आप इसमें उसके eligible नहीं है, उसके criteria में नहीं आते. फिर उसके बाद मेरा 8 महीने के बाद मेरा वायरल लोड के लिए मुझे बोला गया, और वायरल लोड मेरा इतना हाई आया कि मुझे सेकंड लाइन पे रखने का बोला. और मेरा अभी 2 साल से मैं सेकंड लाइन एआरटी ले रही हूँ और अच्छी तरह से जी रही हूँ. पर मेरा 8 महीना जो मैंने बोला, उसके पहले मैंने एक बार बोला तब मेरा वायरल लोड हो गया होता तो शायद मैं अल्टरनेट ऊपर रहती.
मेकिंग द ट्रीटमेंट अवेलेबल has been one big, if I single out one big achievement of the advocacy by the community, treatment has been one. What AIDS has done to the community is to brought them together, you know, and so they are a very strong network.
There has been a significant expansion in number of ART centers. ART service delivery points are now more than 1280, though still these are not sufficient. We want to expand to more. Our coverage for antiretroviral therapy is around 68%. We want to go to 100% success, 100% coverage of all the people who require an antiretroviral. You know, we have now also announced that third line ART would be provided. We are also working towards making viral load monitoring as the major monitoring mechanism rather than the CD4 mechanism. Of 25 drugs or 20 drugs at 1200 sites, there are bound to be some stockouts. But we don't say, we don't justify that. Even a one dose missed is, as we tell patient, even aap ek bhi goli chhodenge to ek din kam ho jayega.
Our vision is that everybody who needs treatment, they should be able to access treatment when they need it.
All the patients, those who were initiated during those 2004 year, so they came forward to me and told, sir, the same program has to be celebrated on the 25th year also, and we assure you that we will be there. And this is the motivating factor for us.
I am very, very lucky that I am in India, first of all. क्योंकि इंडिया जैसी कंट्री, स्पेशली फॉर पीपल लिविंग विद एचआईवी एड्स के लिए, वर्ल्ड में मैंने कहीं नहीं देखी. इतने इंटरनेशनल कॉन्फ्रेंस में गया, और स्पेशली जो हमारी कम्युनिटी है, मैं स्पेसिफिकली एमटीएच कम्युनिटी के बारे में बोलता हूँ कि जो फैसिलिटीज़ यहाँ हैं वो कहीं नहीं.